having been in this field of gut microbiome, it's not exactly, you know, what I dreamed of doing when I was growing up. To be known as, like, you know, the poo guy is a little bit strange. But on the other hand, you know, to help patients improve in their digestive health is exciting. A lot of patients that we work with have digestive issues which cause pain or severe discomfort, but in fact are completely debilitating. By having a stool bank here in Hong Kong to allow them to have access to our treatment and see improvement in their symptoms, see improvement in their condition, is really gratifying. I used to be in pharmaceutical companies and doing drug development, so I've always been interested in looking for new therapeutic opportunities. And about 2 years ago, a friend of mine in Hong Kong got quite ill with a digestive disease and was asking me my opinion of a new therapeutic option called a fecal transplant. And so when he told me this, I thought, that sounds disgusting. That's really strange. You know, my initial reaction was quite apprehensive or skeptical. So I kind of applied my same mentality of evaluating pharmaceutical drug candidates to this field of the gut microbiome, and specifically the fecal transplants, and became quite convinced actually that this is not only an effective treatment for certain kinds of diseases, but actually was going to lead the way into the whole new understanding of human health. Fecal microbiota transplant. It's also abbreviated FMT. It's a very scientific procedure where essentially we are collecting a stool sample from a very healthy donor who's undergone one of the strictest health checkups that can be done. And then in the stool sample, underneath biological safety condition level 2, we're able to extract the bacteria and essentially with this purified bacteria solution, put it into a stable control or a kind of a stable protection, which then as a liquid solution is implanted in the patient via an enema. 2 million people around Asia suffer from inflammatory bowel diseases. Over 70 million people suffer from some form of irritable bowel syndrome. There's a significant patient population in Asia that suffer from digestive diseases, but fecal transplants are not widely known in Asia. It's quite difficult to access that treatment locally. So what we were really trying to do is really expand access to fecal transplants. But I found that the fundraising process to be difficult. We as a company don't really fit into a very clear-cut model. On one hand, we're kind of a medical healthcare business. On the other hand, we're kind of an R&D. And so I think it's been difficult for investors to evaluate us. I think the other challenge for investors is the fact that the whole field of microbiome is new. You know, the first stool bank that really launched globally was in the US in 2012. So that has taken a little bit of time for the field to mature. Fortunately for us, very early on, we had a few angel investors, which was a really great opportunity for me. The main kinds of digestive diseases that we deal with, those diseases are driven by an imbalance in the bacteria. One of the first line drugs used in treating gut illnesses or gut infections is antibiotics. The challenge is that antibiotics are often broad spectrum. They kill a whole range of bacteria, and not just the pathogenic, the harmful bacteria, but they also kill the neutral, the commensal bacteria, or sometimes even kill the probiotic bacteria. That's what's so amazing about FMT, is that the first randomized controlled trial on the use of fecal transplants to treat C. difficile infection and found that it was 3 times more effective than antibiotic treatment, and that actually it had 0 side effects compared to all of the negative side effects of antibiotics. For us, one of the major considerations was safety. You know, how can we ensure that our product is going to be safe for patients to use? So it's difficult to find a good stool donor actually anywhere in the world. They have approximately a 1% passage rate. We have sterile conditions with which to perform the procedure of the bacteria extraction from the stool, and then we store it in a safe environment. So we've taken out an entire community and ecosystem of microbes from a healthy individual, from a healthy donor, and then implanted it directly into a sick patient. It's about bringing the entire gut ecosystem back into balance so that the body can heal itself. Some of the patients, it takes 2 to 3 months really to show long-term benefit or improvement in their symptoms, but we actually do have a significant percentage of patients that show improvement within 24 hours. Probably the most exciting set of studies that are ongoing right now are studies for using FMT for non-gut conditions, such as Parkinson's disease, autism, or even diabetes. We're just at the beginning stages of starting to unravel and unlock the science behind how the body works in the brain-gut connection, the brain-gut axis, or the skin-gut connection, or the skin-gut axis. Okay, there we go.